Moving on to a great topic, topic number six. And honestly, not a big Max Verstappen fan, but he did have a great drive at Monaco and got the win at Monaco in the Monaco Grand Prix.
Yeah, we mentioned the Monaco Grand Prix last week and how excited we were for this race. You know, it's probably the most scenic. A lot of drivers live in Monaco. This is one of the bigger races of the year. It did not disappoint, not necessarily for the competition. I mean, the competition is always good in F1, but the drama that happened, and we're going to talk in the next topic about what happened with Mercedes, because that was just kind of a, you know, what show with them this past weekend. But Verstappen winning another race. And we mentioned, you know, before this F1 season started, you know, is Lewis Hamilton going to be overtaken by somebody else? Is he going to get knocked off the mountain? The guy has been dominant in F1. He has been the top driver for so long. Who's the next driver? Who's the next guy that's going to overtake him? I think the money's got to be on Verstappen, because he's been the one that's been going back and forth with him so far this year. And Red Bull has been the car that's been going back and forth with Mercedes. So you got to look at Verstappen as the guy who is going to challenge Lewis Hamilton. And right now, I think, is it 3-3 now with first place finishes so far in this F1 season? I can't remember the actual... Who has that many first-place finishes so far here in the F1 season, but they both have a few. So yeah. We'll have to look back at that. But this is the guy that's going to challenge Lewis Hamilton. This is the car that's going to challenge Mercedes. It's great for F1. Red Bull has been trying to climb back up to the top, you know, for the last few years. Now they're there, you know, and Verstappen's one of the best drivers in F1. And to win at Monaco is obviously a huge win for Red Bull. You mentioned last week, Brandon, how important it was, qualifying was, because it's tough to pass guys at Monaco because of the track itself. Yep. You see Verstappen did so well this weekend, and Red Bull picking up a win at Monaco Grand Prix, that's huge for them.
Yeah, I mean, Red Bull loves winning at Monaco. They won there a few years ago with Daniel Ricciardo, and I had said, you know, the car's built to go around Monaco. I have said that multiple times. So, it's not a shock to me that they won. And I keep saying, you know, I'm not a big Max fan, and that's because I'm a super Lewis fan, and Max is his number one rival. And trust me, I get it. Hey, man, he deserves all the respect. And I keep telling people, Max is going to be an F1 champion, but it's not going to be until Lewis retires. And trust me, and we're talking about it. And to answer your question, it's 3-2. It's 3-2. Lewis has won 3 and Max has won 2. But right now, Max is leading the drivers' championship because Lewis finished in 7th at Monaco. And so that put him down where I believe Verstappen's worst finish this year is 2nd or 3rd. So in the points difference right now, Max is leading by 4 points in the drivers' championship. But I keep telling people, relax. And like I said, they were bound to win there. The car is much better around tight tracks compared to the Mercedes, okay? So he had the leg up right there. And then Mercedes, like you said, which we'll talk about in the next topic, really fumbled the ball on a pit stop for Bottas and then fumbled the strategy for Lewis. And so they were just on their back foot the whole day, okay? And so Max took advantage of that, and he went out and won the Grand Prix, and he's now leading the championship. However, I'm expecting Mercedes to bounce back. I'm expecting Lewis to bounce back, and I'm expecting him to win the next Grand Prix, maybe even the next couple of Grand Prix. Because when you upset this guy, and I should say when you piss him off, he drives that much better, that much more determined, and now the team's going to be behind him because they know they've made mistakes. So I'm looking forward to a strong Mercedes team coming out in the next Grand Prix. But cheers to Max Verstappen for winning the Monaco Grand Prix, because it's so historic and it's his first Monaco Grand Prix win. And so I know he's going to like cherish that trophy and that win and such a historical track and such a beautiful place and such a beautiful track. But yeah, man, it's such hard, so hard to overtake there. It's really debatable if it should stay on the F1 calendar going forward, because I think a lot of F1 fans would like to see more of a track where we can see more battles and more side-to-side and more wheel-to-wheel racing. But honestly, one of the bigger stories of the race was Charles Leclerc for Ferrari. He was on pole. He had the pole. He had the best qualifying position. He obviously crashed during qualifying too, so that's a whole nother story. But he was supposed to start number one. They go to start up the car on race day, and there's a gearbox issue. There's an axle issue, and he can't even race that day. So it pushed Max Verstappen from P2 on the grid automatically to P1, and he never looked back, and he just went ahead and drove the wheels off that Red Bull and got the win. So it's really one of those things where, hey, it was great to watch. Like you said, a lot of drama in the race, a lot of upset drivers, but a lot of happy drivers as well. But I'm really looking forward to the next Grand Prix, the Azerbaijan Grand Prix in Baku, because we're going to get to see a lot more wheel-to-wheel racing and a lot more exciting action.
Yeah, no question. I would hate to see them take the Monaco Grand Prix off the circuit, because it's just such a famous race. You know, this weekend we had the PGA Championship, NHL playoffs, NBA playoffs. Major League Baseball is in full swing in their second month of the season and almost past 2 months of the season. But folks were still talking about the Monaco Grand Prix here in the United States. You know, you saw it on ESPN, you saw, SportsCenter, and it was part of the sports conversation over the weekend. So I feel like if you move it somewhere else, you sort of take some of the sheen and some of the shine off the luster of that, of the Monaco Grand Prix, because it's such a prestigious race. We always talk about the scenery. Yeah. So I hope they don't move it. I hope it stays there. It's got such a great tradition. I know the track, maybe they can adjust the track a little bit. I know the straights and everything are so tight. You know, I don't know how much room they have, how much slack they have in the track to maybe, you know, make it a little wider or whatever you want to do to enable some drivers to pass other drivers or to overtake some drivers on that track. So I would hate for the F1 to take that off the circuit, but we'll see what happens. I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon, though.